Dear friends, beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. We call this ministry Apostolic Prophetic Bible Teaching Ministry. We just take God's Word the way it is and believe it, whether it's Old or New Testament, whether the Gospels, the Book of Acts, all the rest of the New Testament. We just believe as the Scripture says. We do not tolerate any interpretation. This might sound a little fanatic, but beloved friends, I'm a missionary for over 40 years, could minister in over 130 countries, and now I'm trying to reach the whole earth by the way of TV ministry, because our Lord said in Matthew 24:14, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to all nations as a witness, then the end will be. And again, in Revelation 14:6, we are told about the angel flying through the sky, having the everlasting gospel to be preached to all the nations. And we do remind you, in John 14, our Lord made the promise, I go to prepare the place for you, then I shall return, and I will take you to be where I am. Again, we are told about the signs of the end time, especially in Matthew 24, also in Luke 17, and different places. In Matthew 24, our Lord speaks about all these things which would be in the end time, including all the false Christs, the false anointed ones, the false prophets who would do great signs and wonders, but not take heed to the word of God, not line up with the scriptures, but have their own will and their own way. Then in Luke 17, our Lord speaks about the end of time, and he refers to the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. Beloved, I'm not judging, but the Holy Scriptures right in Genesis tells us that God created Adam in his own image, and then he made a woman, he made Eve, and he brought Eve to Adam, who then said, she is flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. God made woman for man for man, not woman for woman. The divine order must be respected by each and every one on earth. We are part of God's creation and we're made in the image of God, and therefore we should respect the divine order God has placed and set also for the natural creation. Then we understand that things have to be this way so that we recognize that the end time is upon us. Then the Apostle Paul speaks about what would take place in the end time, especially in 1 Timothy 4 and also in 2 Timothy 3. Then again, the Apostle Peter in 2 Peter 3 speaks about the last days, and also in the short epistle of Judas, we find the things pertaining to the end time. Beloved, this is actually God's time for God's people. But we also realize that Satan is bringing everything into a chaos. There is no hope for this world except in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We must differentiate between the will of man and the will of God. Today, if you look into the church world, everyone has a program. Everyone says, I will do this, I will do that, and we'll do this and that. Look into the Roman church. Look into the Protestant churches. Look into all the religions. Look into politics. Everyone has his own will, his own way. At the same time, billions are praying, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, as in heaven, so also on earth. But they don't know the will of God. They are religious. As a missionary, I know most of the main religions on earth. Beloved, it's not enough to be religious. You have to have your personal experience of salvation. You must know of a day in your life when you met Christ as your personal Savior. You must know of an experience when you wept, when the Spirit of God came upon you, and when you repented of your sins and turned from your own ways, from your own will, to the will of God and to the ways of the Lord. Beloved, when our Savior prayed in Gethsemane, He said, Not my, but Thy will be done. And then, if you read in the New Testament, especially in Hebrews chapter 10, speaking about our Lord and Savior, and we must understand that the saved are included in the will of God. We must understand this by divine revelation, that we cannot have our own ways, our own will. We must submit to the will of God and to the ways of God. In Hebrews chapter 10, we read from verse 7, Then said I, Lo, I come. In the volume of the book it is written, To do Thy will, O God. Then the statement comes, Not sacrifices are needed. God wanted His will finally to be done. And when you turn to the Old Testament, to know how the fall came and what happened in heaven and continued on earth, you read Isaiah chapter 14. And here we might start with verse 12. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? Lucifer was a son, a created son, but he fell. How did he fall? You can read it further on in verse 13. For thou hast said in thy heart, I will. Not the will of God at that moment, I will. And to continue, he said, I will exalt my throne. And he continues, I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation. I will ascend above the heights. I will like to be like the Most High. Beloved, we have to understand it was a very good motive, but it was a fall because it was not in reference to the will of God. I will. This is the biggest problem in fallen humanity. God, at the very beginning, expressed his will to the first couple in the Garden of Eden. But there, right in paradise, Satan, the old serpent, beguiled Eve and pulled the first couple out of the will of God, out of communion and fellowship with God. And the first human beings became slaves because they listened to the serpent, beloved, and we're all born in the original sin. This world is still the world of the enemy. The time will come when the Lord of glory will establish his kingdom upon all the earth. So we have to understand all the religious efforts are in vain. They're done in the will of a religion. They are done in the will of a person. It goes back to the beginning, even to Cain, who was of the serpent, as the scripture declares, of the evil, of the wicked one. But he was religious. He prayed. He sacrificed. He talked to God. But beloved, that doesn't mean anything. You have to be in the will of God to have access to the throne of God. You cannot say, I will do this, I will do that. No, thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. What is the will of God? The will of God is that all mankind would come to the knowledge of the truth, but not all mankind receives the word of truth. The knowledge of truth can only come by the word of truth revealed to us by the Holy Spirit, because in God's word, the will of God, the purpose of God, the salvation plan of God is revealed in his own word. And beloved brothers and sisters, let me tell you, it's not enough to speak about Bible characters, to choose Old Testament prophets, and to choose New Testament examples. We ourselves must walk in the footsteps of those who believed God, who trusted God, who obeyed God, who walked in the ways of the Lord. Beloved, there's only one church of Jesus Christ, but there are many churches as denominations. We must make sure that we are part of the church of the firstborn. We must make sure that we know the will of God for today. And to know the will of God for today, you must know the promised word for this day. What did the Lord promise? What should happen before Christ returns? There should be a total restoration of all things. Beloved, I must inform you that as at the first coming of Christ, Bible prophecies were fulfilled, so are now Bible prophecies being fulfilled. Beloved, you can take even the last book. You can read the last 22 chapters of Revelation and maybe give your own explanation to it. But these days are over. No interpretations, no explanations, but divine revelation upon God's holy word. For instance, if we read seven times in Revelation chapter 2 and chapter 3, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. And then it follows, to him that overcometh will I give to eat of the tree of life. Beloved, the promise is always only to the overcomers. Then we have to know what needs to be overcome. What are the obstacles in our way? We must understand the word of God by divine revelation for this day. So there are promises in reference to the first coming of Christ. Isaiah chapter 40 verse 3. A voice cries in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Malachi 3:1. I will send my messenger before my face. You can find it recorded in the four Gospels. These scriptures were fulfilled in the ministry of John the Baptist. He was the prophet who bridged the Old to the New Testament, who prepared the way of the Lord. He did not blow his own trumpet. He was part of God's plan of salvation. A promised prophet like Jesus Christ was the promised Messiah, the promised Savior. So, beloved, we have again a promise that the Lord God would send a prophet like Elijah before the great and terrible day of the Lord would come. It's written in the Old and in the New Testament. Malachi chapter 4 speaks about the day that will come and will burn like an oven. And you go to Isaiah chapter 13 and to different places, right to 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 10. The day of the Lord will come and burn with fire. But before that day comes, at the end of the day of salvation, at the end of the time of grace, which is now, the Lord promised to send a prophet to restore all things. If it would only be in the Old Testament, perhaps I wouldn't mention it, but it's also in the New Testament, not only in Malachi chapter 4, but our Lord repeats it in Matthew 17, verse 11. And Jesus answered and said unto them, Elijah truly shall first come and restore all things. Who are the preachers to take to themselves the authority to deny God's holy word and say we don't need a prophet? They say worldwide, we have Christ, we don't need a prophet. The same already happened in the days of John the Baptist's ministry. What was it? They had their religious services, their ceremonies, their sacrifices, but they didn't receive the man sent from God with the word of God to the people of God. The multitude did, but the religious leaders did not. So is it today. But beloved friends, God watches over his word, and when the time is fulfilled, prophecies become a reality. In our time, in the second part of the 20th century, God used a man in a very special way. His name was William Branham. I'm not part of all the movements connected to his name. I'm just part of God's plan of salvation for the end time. I knew Brother Branham personally for 10 years. I don't preach a man. I don't preach a prophet. I preach Jesus Christ and him crucified. I preach the second coming of Christ. I preach about our preparation to be ready to meet the Lord when he comes. But I also have to tell you that God used William Branham to bring all the Bible teachings back to the church again, about the Godhead, about the water baptism, about the Lord's Supper, all the essential Bible teachings and practices were restored by the God-ordained ministry William Branham received directly from the Lord. He was told, as John the Baptist was sent to forerun the first coming of Christ, you are sent with a message which will forerun the second coming of Christ. God used this man known as Brother Branham to spearhead the healing and salvation revival after World War II. And beloved, many of the great evangelists were inspired in one of his services and took the initiative to also start their ministries. But beloved, here is the big difference. One was called, one was commissioned, one was sent. He did not say on May the 7th, 1946, I am going to do this or that. But he was told on May the 7th, 1946, by the angel of the Lord, he was commissioned to go to the nations and to preach the everlasting gospel to the people. Having received a divine gift of healing, beloved friends, it's a big difference between someone called, commissioned, and sent. That's why the Lord said, I will send unto you Elijah the prophet. And the Lord said, if I send somebody and you receive him, you receive me. And he said, as the Father has sent me, so send I you. Beloved, if I tell you today, with my Bible open before me, I, Brother Frank, heard the voice of the Lord in the German language, like you hear my voice. And the Lord said on April the 2nd, 1962, my servant, your time for this city will soon be over. I will send you to other cities to preach my word. On the day of judgment, I'd like to face you with this statement. Let's summarize what we tried to say here today. Not the will of men in all religions, in every denomination, people have their will and their way. But for God's children, the time has come to walk in the ways of God, to line up with the word of God. The return of Christ is imminent, and therefore, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches by the word of God as it is revealed. Only then you can overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of God. Beloved, may the blessings of God Almighty rest upon you. May you recognize the day and the hour and the message and the messenger, and know that God is making history and time is running out. Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him, and they who were ready went in to the marriage supper, and the door was closed. May you be part at that moment to enter glory as bride with the bridegroom. God bless you and be with you in Jesus' holy name. Amen.